video, we are going to discuss about nadis. As we all know, our body has five sheets, five layers called panch koshas. There are annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, manomaya kosha and anandamaya kosha. We will be discussing about all these koshas in our next video. But in this video, we are going to discuss about nadis, which are very important part of our pranamaya kosha, the energy body. What is the meaning of nadi? Nadi literally means the flow, the current. In English, it is called nerve. Nadis are the subtle channels through which the energy flows throughout our body. These are the fine wire-like structure through which the energy, the prana flows to the end, each section of our body. According to Shiva Samhita, there are 3,50,000 nadis in our body. And according to Goraksha Shatarka, there are 72,000 nadis in our body. So these thousands of nadis distribute the consciousness and the prana, the energy to every atom of the body. If there are any impurities or any blockages in the nadis, in particular area, the energy circulation will be lessened in that area and the body becomes lethargic and the energy level decreases. Therefore, the network of nadis have to be purified using the yoga techniques. Out of large number of nadis, the 10 nadis are very important. And from that 10, the 3 nadis are major important nadis called Ida Nadi, Pingala Nadi and Sushumna Nadi. The Sushumna Nadi is the central channel which starts from your Mooladhara Chakra. Along with the spine, it reaches to the Sahasrara Chakra, the crown of your head. Within the Sushumna Nadi, there are 3 other nadis called Vajra Nadi, Chetrini Nadi and Brahma Nadi, through which the Kundalini Shakti moves upward. Sushumna Nadi is associated with the river Saraswati. Ida Nadi is the left side of the nadi, left channel, which flows from the Mooladhara Chakra. It starts from the left side of the Mooladhara Chakra. It spiral around the Sushumna, passing through each chakra. It reaches to the Agna Chakra at the eyebrow center. When we breathe from left side, we activate the Ida Nadi. And Pingala Nadi start flowing from the right side of the Mooladhara Chakra, spiraling around the Sushumna, and it also reaches to the Agna Chakra, the eyebrow center. When we breathe through the right nostril, we activate Pingala Nadi. So both Ida and Pingala forms a crisscross pathway along the Sushumna, creating a mirror image. Ida and Pingala represents the two opposite forces flowing within our body. Like Ida is passive, introvert and it is feminine. It is also known as the Chandra Nadi, the moon nadi. It is cool by nature and it is associated with Ganga river. On the other hand, the Pingala Nadi is active, extrovert and masculine. It is also called as Surya Nadi or Sun Nadi, which is hot by nature. And it is associated with river Yamuna. So all these 3 nadis start at the Mooladhara Chakra and again while crisscrossing it meet at the Agna Chakra. Generally prana flows from Ida, Pingala and Sushumna alternately. Both will not work at a time. When the left nostril has a greater flow of air, then Ida is predominant. And when the flow is greater in the right nostril, then Pingala is predominant. And when the flow is equal in both the nostrils, then Sushumna Nadi is predominant. When right nostril or Pingala flows, there is more vital energy for physical work, for digestion of food and so on. And the mind is more extroverted and the body generates more heat. On the other side, when left nostril and Ida is active, the mental energy is dominant. And the mind is more introvert and any kind of mental work may be undertaken that time. At night, especially during your sleep, Ida flows predominantly If pingla flows at that time, you cannot sleep.
You feel restlessness and disturbed.
At the time of day, especially after meals, the pingla start flowing. So pingla is predominant at that time. If ida flows at that time, our digestion process will become very slow. It will create the indigestion problem. So all the activities are influenced by these nadis, which works alternately every 60 to 90 minutes. But by using some yoga techniques, we can change the flow voluntarily. The purpose of yoga practices is to balance between your ida and pingla nadi. In fact, the meaning of hatha in hatha yoga, the meaning of hatha is to bring balance between these two opposite energies called solar and lunar energies. When ida and pingla nadis are purified and balanced using yoga techniques, the mind can be controlled and the sushumna nadi, the spiritual nadi, begins to flow easily, and we can meditate easily for long time successfully. The flow of nadis are completely involuntary and unconscious, but we can control this flow using some yoga techniques. We can purify and balance these nadis and chakras so that the kundalini can be awakened and uplift the consciousness. And in order to attain this experience, the regularity is very important. So to get good health and harmony in all these nadis and chakras, keep practicing yoga. Thank you.